¿Qué juega?
I got your message. Coming when called. I think that that's been a difficulty, a little bit of a problem I noticed right from the first time I worked with him. Sometimes, why doesn't a dog come? Why doesn't a puppy come and jump all over you, play with you? It seems like he wants to come. Sometimes he stops a foot or two away. Why is that? Sometimes they associate coming to you with something negative. Maybe you've said, come here, and then shown them what they soiled or what they chewed. Sometimes, if a dog is poorly socialized and afraid of an air conditioning unit outside, and you're standing next to it, and you're calling the dog won't come, not because they're disobedient, but because they're afraid of what you're standing next to. That could be a garbage can. That could be a dominant dog. In this case, I think Zuzu doesn't come all the time because he's like a little bit pretty feisty in that situation. Sometimes we pick them up too much. They come, we call them, and then we think they're little toys. So when we start to do that, they stop there because we're not respecting their space. Well, to overcome it, the other reason is sometimes we're calling the dog when they're engaged in another activity, like barking at the mailman at the window, being out in the backyard, barking at a person at the fence, or barking or chasing squirrels. And if you call the dog and you're saying, come here, and the dog continues to do what they want to, we're actually teaching them they don't have to come when they're called. So all of those things we have to stop doing. Because if we keep doing that, we're going to be taking steps back when we're trying to work forward. I usually like to work on it several ways. You know, one of the first said, it's the very beginning. I want to teach a dog to come and sit close. I don't need to practice from 100 yards away. I want to teach the exercise and make it rewarding. I separate a little bit. I use a short leash. Here, just put the foot in his mouth, back up, and sit. Look how close I can get him. Yes. At first, we're lured, no sit. I don't want him to get up, so I say, here, sit. Now also, if they associate the word come with doing something wrong, maybe we need to change the word to here, or I'll show you you can touch. But I separate, and I'm able to get here. I'm able to get him to sit very close. Now this is called reactive behavior when I'm luring with food. Here, food is low. When I stop, I bring him in closer. Watch, good, good, yes. Separate, no sit. I don't want him getting up till I start, and this goes here, in any direction I want it to go, and sit. Okay, now, reactive behavior is taking a piece of food and luring him. Now, eventually, we start to practice, sit, stay, good sit. I separate a little bit. Now I say, here, and I see if I can get him to come and sit as close. I help a little with the leash, he's a little bit off to the side, which means to me that maybe I need to work more with the food. Here, you're teaching him to come close. Look where I'm holding the food. I'm not raising until he sits. I either could say yes and mark it because that's very close. And with it's like a little piece of string food. Good, good, yes. Separate a little bit. The food, I lure at his level. When I stop, I want to teach him to come and sit close. Yes. Here. Sit. Now, if you say come, maybe you need to change the word to here. Yep. And again, eventually this changes to what we call active behavior. Sit. Now food is like, when you use food for training, it's like keeping a battery charged. When you're still teaching him where you want him to come and he's not perfect, clear that up with a piece of food. Eventually I could even use a piece of toy, a toy. Now I'm going to do it without food. Here. Sit. Now look at that. Yes. Yes means it's like the clicker, you did it right. Now I can work on my well-disciplined sit in front. Good, 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 yes. Now one of the reasons that he wouldn't sit, come fast and sit as close is when we get out with distractions. He's very, very distractive and reactive to noises in the lobby. So we've got to practice more there. We've got to make it where he's calmer out there because again, if he wants to keep turning around and look in the other direction, he's not being disobedient, he's being reactive or afraid. Or we're not motivational enough with our food or our toy. Here, sit, watch, good, good, yes, stay, here. See, I want him here, so I got to go back to always where I'm ready. I'm not going to let him sit in the wrong place. Yes. Now, there's another way of doing this. It's called call to front. When I'm walking him, and this is a good one if he doesn't listen when there's distractions, because let's say I'm walking and he sees a dog or a bird or a squirrel. I just back up. Here, I can make a little tug if I need it. And again, I'm using the piece of food because look how fast and close I can get him to sit. I'll give him half my little piece of food here. say watch, good, good, yes. So whether it's the recall cane, me backing up, or the call to front, I need to practice these hundreds of times so he's used to, well, number one, he has to listen because he has the leash on, and also that he's going to get rewarded, that I'm respecting his space and not picking him up. Here, now that was called air luring. I don't really have food in my hand yet, but he's at, yes. Whatever I have to do to get him to come fast and sit close. Again, I would rather do it without corrections on the leash. Heel. So again, call to front is real good. If he starts to chase something, I can either make a right about turn or just back up here. Now, on stationary exercises, I'm monotone. On come or here or good heel, I want to stimulate. I want them walking on their toes. I want their head up and their tail wagging. Now I can just work on the recall game here. Get them in close. Now you see I'm a little slow, so I'm not going to say yes and pay for that, although it is right between my legs where I want them. Yes? Okay, here. Now, another way is sometimes with a long line, when I have mine on a leash, I'm teaching him to come and sit in front of me. Now, another way of working on recall is I can let him go anywhere he wants now. He's on the long line. And another thing you didn't see is I cut up some freeze-dried liver. So I have a special treat. So I can let him go wherever he wants, do whatever he wants. Here! You should have a pocket full of cookies. Wait, touch. As soon as he touches my hand, now he's also learning, now I might add something else to it, since a lot of times he might think he's going to get picked up. I might call touch. And as soon as he touches, I'll grab his collar. Did you see him lower himself a little bit? It was only a half inch. I don't know if you noticed it. But that's the pressure that makes him not want to come when he's caught. So now, I've got to get that grabbing the collar, first of all, to mean to him that I'm not going to pick him up. And then I grab the collar and I give him a piece of food. Here. Touch. Okay, that was just a touch. This next one, I'll have him sit and I'm going to grab the collar and then give him a piece of food. Here. Sit. Here. See, I took the food out because I want him closer. And now, I'm going to grab the collar and give him a piece of food. Maybe he didn't get as close as he did other times. I just grabbed the collar into him and made a little, slowed him down just a bit.
Good. Good.
Good. Wait, here. Yes. Grab the collar, give him a piece of food. Pet. Respect his pay, his space won't pick him up all the time. Now instead of using food, real quick, I could also be using a toy. I'll make a little video on that.